In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the Lord is good, and always the Lord is good. I request your prayer. Please pray for me. Last 1 month I'm suffering with a frozen shoulder, and my sugar is gone up. My medicine is changed. Please continue to pray for me so that God may keep me well, so that I can do His ministry which God has entrusted to me to do. This morning we have heard 3 testimony which the Lord is doing through the website, and I hope you all have testimony in your life, right? Praise the Lord. Do you have testimony in your life? Yes. People of God, they have testimony, every kinds of testimony. And the Lord is using not only our church website, but He is using us. And we are happy to be involved in His kingdom ministry. And the Lord will continue to use those who will not compromise with the world. There is a quotation. A man called Ayn Rand, he said, "To sell your soul is the easiest things in the world." That's what everybody does every hour of life. Today we are living in a world where there are full of choice. In a certain church, there was a selection of new board. The procedure was going on, and it was a very tough time for the pastor to conduct the selection procedure. One of the member of his congregation asked, "Reverend, is it okay? Everything is fine?" The pastor said, "No, brother, everything is not fine." Then the member of that congregation, he loved the pastor. He is a well-wisher of the pastor, and he said, "Reverend, don't try to swim against the current." And he said, "Go with the flow and you will save yourself." Friends, we are living in this sinful world. We are living in a defiled world, and we are living in a deceived world. Often our lives are filled with choice. Our effectiveness in the kingdom of God and our usefulness to God determine our decision when we stand in the crossroad of life. It is the imperative that we make a godly decisions. A born again Christian, a believer, member of Union Church, it is the imperative that we must make a godly decisions. Now, in our text today, which I've read to us, it is not a text to us, because we know the life of Daniel. In every Christian home, Daniel is one of the character is taught. A man who stood for his faith. In this text we find these 4 Hebrew young men, and they took the bold step to stand firm for their faith. Because they overcome the compromise which the king offered to them, they conquered the compromise, therefore they could conquer fire, lion, and their enemies. Many times we as Christians, we have compromised with the world, we have compromised with the sin, we have compromised with our Christian marriage standard. Christian boys getting married to the unchristian girl. Christian girls getting married to the unchristian. Non-Christian. And the strange thing is, the parents, the Christian parents, they give consent. And they say, no, they are not listening to us. They are modern, they are postmodern children. My friends, the word of God remains forever and ever. God never changes and God never changes His word. His word stands forever and ever. Now this morning, what I am trying to do is, let us look at the text and find out these four young people and how they could overcome the compromise that is being offered to them. My friends, if you want to stand for the truth of God's word, you will have problem. In the world, you will have problems. People may not accept you. People will not appreciate you. People will not praise you. People will give you troubles and problems if you stand for your faith. Now in this text we see these Hebrew young people, they have problems. And their problem is different kind of problem. This morning I would like to say few things about their problem. Number one, we see this Hebrew young people, they are born and brought up in and around Jerusalem. They were constantly reminded of their God. They were constantly reminded the importance of God in their life. And they were reminded the importance of temples, coming to the temples. They were also reminded of the sacrifice which was being offered in the temple. And the prophets were preaching the word of God. Now these people, their problem is they have given a new place. They were taken to Babylon. Now, in our church, our children, they come to Sunday schools to learn the word of God. It is nice. Our youth, they come for Bible studies. We are teaching them, training them, guiding them. In the Christian Endeavor Union, the young people, they come and learn the word of God. Doing everything for them, some of the children, the young people, they lead a wrong kind of life. Now these young people, in our language, if you say they have a very good Sunday school, very good Bible study group, very good parents, and they were very well disciplined. Now they are taken into Babylon. In Jerusalem they were free people, but in Babylon they are a slave. They have no freedom. They are surrounded by the heathens. They are surrounded by the heathen worship, heathen images, and heathen people and heathen culture. Let me tell you this morning, it is easy to be spiritual in the church. When you sit in the church, we feel very spiritual. When you come to the church, we feel very spiritual. It is very easy to be godly around godly people. But when you go out from the church, nobody is seen in the church. But when we go out from the church, in the world, where there are different kind of compromise approaching us, where we are there, where we are have to make a decisions, there we fail. There we forget God. However, these young people, they did not lose their faith. Godly atmosphere, godly surrounding will help us sometime. When we do not participate in the body of Christ, in the church service, we are placing ourselves in the dangerous position. We are opening up our life to the possibility of compromise. It is very important, as a believer in Christ, we must regularly come to the church. We must regularly read our Bible. It is essential that we surround ourselves with God's people. The second problem they face is the new knowledge. Knowledge is wonderful. We want to learn new things. We want to learn so many things. These Hebrew young people, they are taught a new language, a new way of living, new way of looking at life. All their life they had been exposed to Jewish wisdom. Now they are taught the wisdom of Babylon. They were exposed to things they have never been exposed before. It is a dangerous time for them. When our children, when they come to Sunday school and learn about God and the Bible, when they finish their 10th standard, when they enter into the college, they start asking questions about God. They ask, whatever written in the Bible, is it true? They ask question, is Bible relevant today? And one student, he asked me, Pastor, who created God? God is the creator. Now there is a much pressure on them to conform to the Babylon standard of life. They are forced to live like a Babylonian. They are forced to look at life in the world point of view, not God's point of view. My friends, today we also face the same problem. New knowledge. Getting new knowledge is not bad. But the knowledge that is working against God's knowledge, we should deny. Now for our young people, Bible reading is no more important. Because they have so many textbooks to read and very thick textbooks to read and prepare for their exam and for their career, they have no time to read Bible. Reading Bible is not important. Personal devotion time is not important. New knowledge. Bible memory verse is not important. Now, they memorize Bible verse for the competition. To get reward, to get prizes. It is okay to have little bit of alcohol drinks. It is okay to do everything that pleases me. New knowledge. My friends, the Sunday school certificate will not give your children a good job in a reputed company. But remember this, the university certificate will not give your children, it will not take you to heaven. But the Sunday school certificate, if your children have studied the word of God, it will help you to live a godly life. God's word is sure, it is settled, it is right. Psalm 119 verse 89 says, "Forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven." Forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. And these young people, they have given a new food. Now, food is the basic necessity of life. We all eat food, good food. We all like good food. When you grow in age, there are certain restrictions. There are certain food we should not eat. Now, before I had a sugar, I like very much sweets. Now there is a restriction. I cannot eat sweets. If I eat sweets, the sugar will increase. These young people, they like food, good food. And if you want to know it, go to Bhubaneswar, go around Bhubaneswar, you find so many restaurants. And in the restaurant, you find young people are sitting there in eating. When my son was 4 years old, he was purely vegetarian. We tried to give him the non-vegetarian food, he denied. Now when he passed out from the 10th standard, now he became the non-vegetarian. Young people, they like food. Now here is the king's royal food, the non-vegetarian food is offered to these young people and they say no. Because these young people, they live by the dietary law given by the Lord. Now they face a problem. In order to survive in Babylon, they have to eat the non-vegetarian food, the unclean food by the Jewish standard, the meat which was offered to the idols. If they eat this food, they will defile themselves. But if you read verse 8, Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with the portion of the king's meat, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore he requested the prince of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. Clean and unclean. Clean food and unclean food. Clean entertainment and unclean entertainment. Clean music and unclean music. Now after going back from the church, young people, please check your mobile. What kind of pictures you have in your mobile? What kind of songs you have in your mobile? Well, you have Bible in your mobile. Many young people, they have Bible in their mobile. Also, unclean music in your mobile. But here is four young people, they says, we will not defile ourselves. With the king's meat, we will not defile ourselves. For them, there is a challenge. There is a danger of compromise. But they requested the eunuch, who is in charge of the providing ration, give us the vegetable and water. Many of our Christian young men, even they don't have shame to come to the pastor and ask money for wine. Pastor, can you give 100 rupees? But here is a Hebrew young man. Four Hebrew young people. They said, we will not defile ourselves with the king's food and king's wine. Friends, nothing will ever change but the choice I make in life can either build me up or tear me down as servant of God. Therefore, it is extremely important that we constantly guard ourselves. There is a saying, prevention is better than cure. Now the fourth problem they face is the new name. When the young people arrived in Babylon, they had name, a wonderful name. Each name carried a testimony to the person of God. Daniel, which means God is my judge. And Hananiah, which means God is gracious. And Mishael, which means God is without equal. And Azariah, which means the Lord is my helper. Now their name is changed. They carry a wonderful testimony of God's nature. Now their name is changed. They are given a new name. Daniel became Belshazzar, which means Baal will protect. Daniel, God will not protect you. It is God who will protect you. Hananiah, the name changed to Shadrach, inspiration of the sun. And Mishael, Masak, belonging to Akku. And Azariah, Obednego, the servant of Nego. Now why Nebuchadnezzar, the king, changed their name? What is his goal? The goal is to change their identity. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, if you are truly born again, if you are truly accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, the devil is day and working. Day and night he is working to change your identity. Because your identity comes not by your name, not by what you do in this world. Many people, they carry their identity, their titles, and they come to the church. Your identity comes from Christ and Christ alone. If you want to know yourself, look at the cross. And devil is trying to destroy your identity by changing your name, by changing your food habits, by changing everything. Even their name is changed, but their character remains intact. Sometimes we call people the way they behave. We give a special name. But these four young people, their name was changed. But the king cannot change their character. No matter what they say, no matter what the world says or what the world will do, constantly remind yourself that you are born again children of God. You are a born again children of God, twice born. If you remind yourself and remain in Christ, then no compromise can overcome you. You can overcome, conquer any kind of sin and compromise. Now they have purpose. They dedicated themselves. the king could change their name, their home, their diet, their education, their philosophy, but the king could not change their heart. These young people, they decided to serve the Lord. Whatever the cost may be, they wanted to serve the Lord. Now, they have every reason not to serve the Lord. Now, today, in Christmas worship service and New Year worship service, our churches are full. And first Sunday of the month, the churches are full. Because in the first Sunday, we have a Holy Communion service. People think if they come to the church and receive Holy Communion for whole month, they are blessed, no evil will happen to them, and they are safe. But other Sunday, they have some reasons not to come to the church. Thank God you have come to the church. Now this young man, they have every reason not to serve the Lord, because they have taken into Babylon, their food is changed, their name is changed, their education is changed, everything is changed. Now, they are in a strange land and they have a very reason to live like a Babylonian. But they purpose in their heart, they dedicated themselves to the Lord and they desire to serve the Lord. They make an effort to maintain their ceremonial purity. When you take steps of faith in the times of compromise, and God helps you, God honored their faith. God honored their faith. But let me tell you, it will not always be easiest things or most popular things for you to take your stand with God. It will not be easy. It will not be a popular idea to stand for God. People, those who are around you, they will not understand you. But it is the right thing to stand for God. Today, what we need today is not a big theology or big doctrine, but the same level of commitment which Shadrach, Meshach, even Abednego had. The same level of commitment which Daniel had. We need the commitment. We compromise with many things. We compromise with our speech. We compromise with our dress. We compromise in our lifestyle. We compromise in our music. We compromise in our job. Now this morning, we need to rededicate ourselves to live for the Lord. These young people, they dedicated themselves. And their dedication was summed up in two words: faith and obedience. Faith in God and obedience to God's word. And we as a believer in Christ, we must have faith in God and we must obey Him. Those who honor God, God will honor them. Now after 3 years, those who eat the king food, the royal wine and the royal meat. Now, these young people, those who ate the vegetable, their face is 10 times better than the people ate the king's food. And they were given a honor. My friend, this morning, before I close, do you face any compromise in your life? Maybe that compromise is very, very, very small thing. It appears like a very tiny temptation. It is a silly temptation. There was a redwood tree of 400 years. One day the tree crumbled down, and the people, they investigated why the tree has fallen, and they found out. In the closer inspection, they found out a tiny beetles had found their ways inside the trunk, and as a result, the huge tree, big tree, has fallen. Maybe a tiny silly temptations, a tiny silly sin, which people of the world, they do not consider it is a sin. It might have crept into your life. But we see the young people, they said, we will not defile ourselves with the king's meat. They were dedicated to the Lord. They had a commitment to the Lord. This morning, let us rededicate ourselves. And let us live for the glory of God. And God will certainly bless us. Let us pray. Our Holy Father, we thank you for your precious word. We thank you, Lord, for the strength that you have provided to your servants. And we thank you, Lord, for the strength and the power that is available to us by your Holy Spirit. Lord, this morning, once again, we rededicate our life. Lord, help us not to defile ourselves. Lord, as we serve your God, give your grace. Help us, Lord, to overcome every temptation of this life. Help us, Lord, to lead a victorious life that you have given to us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Father, thank you for speaking to us this morning. Continue to speak to us, O Lord, as we depart from this place. May your Spirit, may your peace rest upon us. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.